You're the one who's always yelling about how he needs discipline. You want it out? I'm giving you a helping hand.
I take it you've decided to move me into this swank bachelor pad here?
I figured you need a little motivation. I don't care what y'all do, just don't call me.
Avoiding confrontation, Warwick? You know, it's not that easy to find an apartment for $1.98. And as if you didn't notice, I can't pay the bills for two places at once. And it wasn't my idea in the first place. It was your darn marriage counselors. Never should have gone.
Huh? Dad, long distance.
John here. Uh-huh. I see. Now, you got the wrong number. Am I sure about that? Yeah, I think I'm pretty sure about that. You got the wrong John Claiborne.
Who's that?
Nobody. Go play.
Get out there and get it. Now. John, put the gun down. Put it down!
Get up. Let's go.
Where?
For once in your little short life, will you stop asking so many questions? Come on.
I didn't even brush my teeth. You didn't even take a shower.
I'll take a shower when I get to Mississippi.
I'm not going to Mississippi.
That's right, you're not, because I'm going to take you back to your mom's house.
She said don't even call. And you're going to drop me off? I know you're not that stupid.
You think she's going to be mad?
Furious. It was the right number, huh? And you need me, Dad. I doubt you'd get down there and back by yourself. It's 200 miles.
What is it? Hunter?
It's a 1942 C-47 with a DC-3 conversion. Was she a girlfriend?
No, nothing like that.
Then why are we here?
It's complicated.
Hey, look at this.
Cool.
Well, we were sure one day they'd miss. We used to watch them right up there. Kill Devil Hill, I called it.
Homage to the Wright brothers.
You and your friend?
Zeola.
Zeola? Stupid name.
There weren't that many kids around here, especially boys, and I guess she wasn't really a kid.
How long do we have to stay here?
Will you put that game down for 1 second and come out here?
Why? I've seen a zillion crop dusters.
Fine. Stay there.
I'm not. I'm slow. That white stuff will kill you.
It's just DDM or DDQ.
DDT.
Kills baby heads like you.
I ain't no baby head. I'm 32 years old and Donny Osmond's coming to my birthday party.
Donny Osmond has better things to do. He has to be on TV. Stop following me.
I'm not. I'm going home.
Then just shut up and walk.
I don't shut up. I throw up and then you eat it up. Hey. Mr. Lowe's gonna call your daddy and you're gonna get a big old whooping.
You're not.
Cha-cha, come here. Cha-cha, you got ticks all over you.
Get them off, get them off.
Ooh, only one thing will work.
Now you wanna pull your body through the move, okay? Breathe in and out. Meditation is the key to getting in touch with your soul. Did you know that in India that the cows were sacred? Well, they're vegetarian, of course, Erlene. Now remember, breathe in and out. Erlene, focus. You want to breathe in and out.
Is it working? Well, is it?
I don't know.
Burn them off! Go, go! There's matches in there! Stop! God, sleep! Zeola! No! Zeola! No! Zeola!
Time for you to go home.
Ticks are hardest to kill. They burrow under the skin, you know. I gotta go home now. Bye. Bye, Erlene. Bye.
John, if your father caught her with you, he'd pop a hernia. I know you have a kind heart, but you've got to find another friend. I hear the Gibbs grandson is coming this summer, be about your age. Anyway, dam's over in Nam, a real war hero the way they tell it. Must be a different Dan, because in high school he couldn't even with the knitting team. Erlene, don't just stand there. I'll go to the store today. Go on, go on. Gotta get me some things for dinner. And you. Is that all?
That's $10.
Shoot. Rolling Stone comes in today. Well, no way to get the darn smell out.
I... I bet there ain't no ticks in San Francisco.
Smells like gasoline in here. Hey, Stinky, you gonna eat or read? Can't you just simply fry a dang chicken? And where's my tea?
I made that chicken, Mr. Billy Joe.
What do you think you're doing? Isn't that yours?
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Just shut up and be more careful.
Antenna's still on the fritz, and the Beatles are going to be on Johnny Carson next week.
Lord moves in mysterious ways.
Here you go.
Now get on out of here. Sandra, you got to keep a closer eye on things around here. What the heck is this?
It's Coco Van. That's French for chicken baked in wine sauce.
Where are you getting such fancy ideas?
A recipe I found.
One of them hippie rag magazines you insist on wasting money on? Here you drove your bug mobile to town today.
I had to shop. Everything on the plate is fried, for Christ's sake.
Let's not be using the Lord's name in vain here.
I'm just saying that the okra is fried. The green tomatoes are fried. This cornbread is fried. The only this that is baked is the chicken.
Well, we can't eat this.
Daddy, did you know the first flight lasted 12 seconds?
Yeah, I know.
They called it an engine kite.
I got a surprise in the car for you, John. John. Wait a minute, wait. Not till you finish all that darn baked cock leaven you suddenly like so much. Hello. Yeah, hey, hello. What can I do for you? Sorry to cause you the trouble. It won't happen again.
John, John, get your butt in here. What did I tell you yesterday, the day before that, and the day before that?
Not to be up on that hill.
It's a dimwit Zeola. She ain't got sense to pour piss out of a boot.
She followed me. I couldn't make her go away.
And the hill?
It's the best place to see the plane.
Half this country's got cancer from all the chemicals, and you're out there playing in them. You will learn to listen to me.
Billy Joe, that's enough.
See what you made me do? Don't tell me how to raise a son. You know nothing about discipline, and neither does he.
Oh, guys, you better go to the store. Get yourself a bottle of real perfume. Besides using all the spices in the house.
You better hope you can't get that top off. You already about big as our front porch.
I don't need no babysitter to tell me when to eat and when not to eat. You don't have to do those towels.
Oh, I'm just about finished with the bath towels. I'm on the sheets now. Did anybody call?
No.
Are you absolutely, positively cross your heart hope to die sure?
That phone ain't rung all day. I don't think it's rung all week. Come to think of it, I can't remember the last time that phone rang. Why?
Because I can't tell you.
Might as well go on and let that dress out.
You know there are planes 2 stories high with a cocktail bar even. We'll go somewhere in one someday. The age of Aquarius is dawning, and I don't want to be stuck here frying chicken.
He'll be fine after breakfast.
No, he won't.
You have to promise me never to go on that hill again. Okay?
I'm building my own plane now.
Sure, honey. Then we can fly on out of here anytime we want. We'll go to San Francisco. Find a little peace, love, and happiness.
I don't want you playing with Zeola. And I think she could be dangerous.
Well, who am I gonna play with then?
Well then, you be careful.
Ever heard of chocolate syrup on a biscuit?
9 whole days to my birthday.
10.
You can't count today. It's almost over. I invited Donnie Osmond.
Baby, can you save me some of that syrup? I hate for you to have to eat that biscuit plain. Why don't you put some of that caramel on it?
I want to have a big, big party.
Can't too many people come to a party on a Sunday, especially them Baptists.
Can I have Blue Twisted Screamers?
Baby, you can have the party, but don't be surprised if don't too many people show up.
Oh, they will when they hear that Donnie's coming, and my best friend John John, he'll come.
He your best friend?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I guess he's all right. I don't know about his mother and that dumb little thing she call a car.
Calls it a bug.
Well, she right about that.
I'll have to get some more when I go to the store today.
Can you send me a postcard?
She's just going to the store. You send a postcard when you're going way off. And Mel, on his way to the market. I expect he after that day old bread. He figured it's not quite a day old if he get there early enough.
John John, can you come to my birthday party next Sunday?
You're late, no way.
Why?
Just because. Is that it?
Yeah, but you can only use it if you come to my party. Donnie Osmond's coming.
In your dreams.
Meanie.
I'll let you wear the rope.
Hang on.
Is the knot really tight?
Yeah.
When I get high enough, sit down. It'll be like a kite. Can you remember that?
Like a kite and sit down.
Ready?
Ready.
Clapton was busted for smoking pot. Look at here, Elaine. Don't he look good? Oh, okay. So
No one compares to this new sunny boy of yours.
When we go to San Francisco, I'm gonna get new hair, do something about these big old teepees of mine, and I'm gonna come back here and I'm gonna marry that sunny boy, Thomas.
I can do your hair. Hey, we could get a free Tiny Tim album if we send off for a subscription.
Uh-huh.
By Christmas, I'm teaching you to drive.
Sister, I don't need to drive. I get to where I'm going.
Well, wait 2 minutes, then honk the horn.
Why?
Because that'll give me an excuse not to have to stay in there so long.
Ain't you just about as smart as the good Lord makes them?
Hello.
Hi.
I'm sorry for the intrusion, Miss Claiborne.
Oh, not at all. It's nice to see you. How about some lemonade or iced tea? Earlene just baked some cookies. Why don't you ask your sister to join us?
Oh no. See, my sister, she's kind of old and feeble and crazy in the head. Maybe just for a minute.
Earlene, did you leave something on the stove? It smells like black pepper steak.
Can you build a real plane?
Will you keep your voice down? I never should have said anything.
Why is it a secret?
Cause it is. What's the difference between a model plane and a real thing? Scale, that's all.
Can I help?
No way. That's too complicated.
You'll be going off to San Francisco, won't you? Well, your mom is always talking about it, and Earlene, too. Promise to send me a postcard.
All right. I guess you can watch. Just don't go blabbling this to anyone, okay?
Of course we'll stop by her birthday party.
She don't know many folks, and it would mean so much to Mazziola. I call her man because she's been with me over 26 years. Seems like my own. One day her mama just up and left. I've been working for that woman over 30 years, and I didn't see it coming. I ain't seen nothing of her since, except one little old postcard. Poor little Ozeola didn't have nobody. A sweet girl. Nothing wrong with her mind. Just had a fall when she was young. How's Mr. Billy Joe? I remember when he was this high.
Fine. Just fine.
Well, I'll see you around 3. You don't have to stay long. Better put some on that lip. Why don't you come too?
Yes, ma'am, but I don't have nothing to wear.
I'll bring my portable record player. Earlene will have to get some new records.
Oh, don't go through no trouble. Well, I'll get on then. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Bye.
I can't depend on you for nothing.
But y'all seem to be having such a nice time.
I ought to make you drive.
What kind of cookies are those?
Now look. I need all these pieces, but bigger.
You'd fly like a real plane.
Yeah, I'm nigger-igging.
That word shows your ignorance. Can we name it Donnie?
I'll think about it.
He's coming to my party.
Yeah, I'll believe it when I see it.
You get to meet him.
I already told you. I ain't coming to your party. I gotta get some things.
I'm not. I'm going home. Mr. C's got plenty of stuff to build a plane with.
He's nothing but a lunatic that shoots anybody who comes near his stuff.
He used to be an astronaut.
Nuh-uh.
Oh, you're just mad because you know you can't really build a plane. And you don't want me to see you crash and blow up.
Ziola, close your eyes and count to 10. I got a surprise for you.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Expect you aren't interested in buying that lawnmower.
I am, sir.
It's not for sale. Name?
Claiborne. I'm Billy Joe Sloan.
Don't know him. Now get out of here.
I'll give you $5 for it. What is it, crank?
It's as sure as a man standing on the moon.
Everybody says one day you're going to the moon.
I'm crazy, but I ain't that crazy. I just build rockets. I don't ride them. Now get on off my property.
What's that in your pocket?
Nothing.
We ain't no fools, Ziola.
I found it at the hermit's house. It was just kind of lying in front of me, and, well, it's yours, and I made a mistake, and I'm sorry, Mr. C. Please don't shoot me.
I suppose those ladies expect me to teach you a lesson.
Oh, probably not. They just afraid of you because you crazy old hermit. The whole town says so.
Yeah, it's true enough. Keep most people away.
Why don't you like people?
Don't see no need for them.
Like Francis said, the space people didn't need you on account of you didn't have no common sense.
Is that what that old coot said? Well, you listen to me. I was the smartest man in my whole darn department. I told him 10 years ago we'd be up there dancing on the moon one day, and I will be right. I told him we'd be up there selling snow cones to those little green Martians, and I'll be darned if I ain't right. So you tell me if I'm crazy. And so what kind of lesson you need to be taught?
Okay. How about this, Herlaine? Look at that. Outfit.
Mm-mm.
Red's my favorite color. Oh. Oh, Miss Claiborne. You used to be so pretty. Mm.
Sandra, mm-hmm. Not again.
Mm-hmm. It is 1968, for Christ's sake, and we are going to have a cup of coffee at Earl's. Mm-hmm. Do it up.
Okay.
Get on.
I do not look good. And my hair? Oh, Sonny Boy ain't gonna ever look at me.
Yes, he will. Now stop already. We're gonna have to buy some records for the party.
Maybe one.
Well, that's all the grocery money we got left.
Just because Billy Joe thinks you're so darn good with money does not mean you have to be so darn stingy with it. How much did he give you this week anyway?
Same as always.
I'll be the Claiborne woman on the way to the record store, I expect.
I don't think I should go first.
Well, of course you should. That's the whole point.
You go first. And, you know, break the ice.
The whole point is that you should not stand behind me. You have every right to walk through that front door.
Billy Joe's gonna come apart when he hears. Are you ready for that?
I don't care about Billy Joe. We are revolutionaries.
Yeah, well, I don't even like coffee.
Darn it, Arlene. I don't want my idea of progress to get you in trouble. How much money do we have again?
Enough for a record, maybe two.
Okay.
You didn't have very much laundry, Mr. C. And most of it needs fixing.
Well, I suppose you learned your lesson. But if you and your friends trespass again, I'll be obliged to shoot.
Oh, I know. I'll be careful. What about them socks?
You got to take care of yourself in this world, Missy. I'm pretty used to taking care of myself.
But you can't seem to take care of them socks.
And just what do you want for this extra service? It wouldn't have anything to do with my lawnmower, would it? Now, why is everybody so interested in my lawnmower?
It's a secret on account of his escape plan. But maybe you can guess.
What'd y'all do today? John John, you didn't go up on that hill today, did you?
The boy is not crazy.
I just like watching the crop dusters, that's all.
Francis stopped by today. Invited us to Ziola's birthday party.
Living with a bunch of niggers.
Don't use that word. Shows your...
Well, John John's got himself a new girlfriend. Guess you didn't hear about your boyfriend today, huh?
What are you talking about?
Turn that darn record player off, listen to something else once in a while, you might know. Probably still on the radio. Bobby Kennedy got himself shot today. I told you he'd not be elected, not in this country. Guess that's the end of that.
Can I be excused?
You're not getting soft on me, too, are you, John boy? I didn't hear you.
No, sir.
Daddy said he saw you uptown in that stupid car of yours today. Go buy a bunch more of that hippie drug music. I don't want that crap influencing my boy anymore. Get it? This country's coming apart. People getting killed, a lot of it because of these rich whining brats you keep thinking are so smart. And the truth is they've never worked an honest day in their life. What is it with you? I didn't run out on you, did I? And I ain't planning to every other minute, and that's a lot more than I can say for you.
You told me we could stay in New Orleans.
Knees break. That's the luck of the damned.
You said it. Well, I still got places to go.
Like it or not, you still got responsibilities right here. You got no right dreaming about being some Kennedy-loving, drugged-up hippie. And I thought we agreed. No more Jim Dyke Joplin, Jimmy Drugged Up Hendrix, and who's grateful to be dead?
No! Billy Joe Claiborne, that cost over $50.
Then you owe me. What do you think you're gonna do with those? Come here, son. Don't make me ask you twice. Throw it.
Come on.
Half those people are on dope. Get your arm into it now. They're bringing chaos into this country. And that's your future, boy. You got to think about that. You got to have discipline to get through what God's going to do to you. You got to stand for something. That's what being a man is. You get, go, throw it. You get that right, you'll be somebody. Maybe somebody important. Now, go get my gun. Shoot that record player. Something bothering you?
Viola, you in the bed?
No, ma'am. I'm looking at the postcard from Mama.
Well, you done looked at it long enough. Now go to bed.
See, how you can come in. Thanks for the lawnmower.
How'd you know that?
I just know. Did you steal it?
No way. I never would. Mr. C has laundry, and I know how to do that. I'm a good girl, and I still have $5 that Mrs. Kendricks gave me for my birthday.
I guess you can help for the day, but don't be following me, okay? And don't be stupid.
Slow.
Theola, do you hate your dad because of what he did?
I don't have one.
You can't be born without one. Everybody knows about your accident. Do you hate him for it?
I don't know. He left. But I like your daddy.
He's as mean as a snake.
Well, he looks nice.
Well, he ain't.
I wish Donnie Osmond's father was my daddy.
He's a sissy.
Nuh-uh. I'm going to marry him, and we're going to be happy because everybody's happy on TV, and he's coming to my party.
In your dreams.
Yep. Just like San Francisco.
What are you talking about?
You and your mom. You want to go to San Francisco, so you dream this up. And now, look, it's going to be a real plane. Oh, do you promise you'll send me a postcard?
Yeah, come on. We got to get some cotton.
Look. That was easy. You want to see me put it back together and do it all over again?
Or you just do me a favor and shut up?
They don't have any airplane wings in here.
Would you just shut up?
How much money do you have?
$5. We're just checking prices.
I don't need no smart alex in my store.
Do you have
any... That cotton I bought before.
That cotton you bought before? Well, good grief, kid. Like, I can remember who bought what. This is a very busy store. I think I know what you want. That'll be $1.
$1?
All right, free. But you and your big old friend there gotta buy something.
I need a fine leaf cotton, 200 threads per inch, grade A, or Irish linen. Sir, that's all I can buy.
Well, I'm just fresh out of the 200 weave grade A. Mother Sue bought the whole boat. Lord, she bought enough to build a sail for that. What was the name of that ship?
The Titanic.
You idiot, the Mayflower.
Don't you touch nothing.
Let's go, Ziola.
Hey, can I help you?
Yeah, I'd like some of those pig feet.
Y'all ain't waiting no more!
You want pig's feet?
By chance, you know a Ziola? You know a Ziola?
Where are we going next on the memory road? Hillbilly Homestead?
Hunter, what did I tell you? Don't you dare. Don't you dare take a bite of that! Get over here!
Some dad you are!
Get in the car.
No.
How much patience do you expect me to have?
None, Dad. You're not capable of it.
Get in!
No!
All right, I'll make you a deal. We finish a day, go by the old house, then we drive home. Straight through, I'll find your mother, and you never have to set eyes on me again.
Just make it quick.
Beatcha! You got a head start, cheater.
Hey, John, I don't think
Shut up and let me do all the talking.
Yeah, I know, but
her name... Be quiet, Ziola, or I'm gonna build a plane myself. Hello, Mrs. Shue.
My name is Good. G-O-O-D, no E, Good. That's me. Took every last one of them kids in when they didn't have no place else to go. Now people are going around town calling me names behind my back, and I don't appreciate that one iota. Hey, Ziola, nice to see you again. What can I do for you, sugar?
Old man Todd at the store told us you bought the last of his cotton. We were wondering, if you hadn't used it all up, we might buy some.
Well, spent most $1.50 for that material, but I guess I could let you have 10 yards for, say, $10.
No, see that crease right there? You need to get that crease.
Mr. Billy Joel's got a business trip next week.
Yeah, I know. San Francisco always be there. Billy Joe'd kill me first and John be next. He wants to travel with that hanging over their head. Dixon's Mustang. Must be off with Lydia again. One day her father's gonna catch him and haul his butt off for good.
You can't drive 100 feet without everybody knowing your business in this town. You're gonna have to sprout wings.
I told you I'm not going anywhere. Wings or no wings.
You mean you're gonna stay here for the next 100 years? Remind me what Mr. Billy Joe said.
Might as well leave this ramp. You're gonna get old one day.
I do hope the Lord has blessed us this week. I want to thank Sister Porter for the AstroTurf on the front door steps. Brother Vince from New York City is here, staying with his grandparents, Mr. and Mrs. Gibbs, for the summer. And oh, it is so nice to see all of these young people in the Lord's house today. And his brave father is a pilot in Vietnam, where we fight for the freedom for those that cannot fight for themselves. Let us pray for the safety of him.
That's nice.
Huh? What's your dad for?
A Phantom.
Did he ever take you up?
I was in a B-52 once.
Wow. The only thing he ever seen fly is a crop duster.
Too slow.
Would you sit outside?
You could spit on people.
I've been thinking about building this plane. Kind of like a crop duster. You know, for kicks.
I got a coupon in a bubblegum wrapper that says you can get a kit plane for $39.95, plus 100 gum wrappers.
I could chew 100 pieces of gum. That ain't nothing. It's probably just a model.
Nope. Says it's the real thing. Comes already built. A two-seater. I was thinking I'd ask my grandfather for it. He just bought me a new motorbike. So what's your name?
John.
Vince, I guess if I'm going to be stuck here all summer, you might as well come over sometime.
Daddy, did y'all get your cows back up okay?
I'll be a lame butt by pretending to be interested in my cows. Ow! Katie got way too much sugar in his tea. I can't drink this. Give me some water.
Sandra, you're not eating?
Well, you see, I've been doing a lot of reading lately, and I don't believe that meat is all that good for you. I'm thinking about becoming a vegetarian.
Really? Well, where were you reading about such ridiculous things?
The Buddhists don't eat meat. It's part of their religion.
Sandra, just shut up.
Buddhist? You becoming a Buddhist now? I guarantee you, the leather on your shoes comes from some poor little old animal. You gonna stop wearing shoes?
I wish you would. Her closet won't hold anymore. Maybe there's something to this vegetarian stuff.
Don't you like my chicken?
No. I mean, yes. There are whole nations of vegetarians. In India, the cow is sacred.
Well, the cow is sacred to the farmer, too. But you wouldn't know about that, being the wife of a handyman. Or whatever it is you do.
Thank you, Mom. That was good.
Billy Joe hitting you. Couldn't be any worse than his father. You know how these men folks are around here.
That doesn't make it right.
Think about John John. He's all I think about. But Billy ain't a bad boy. And they get softer with age, you know.
Well, isn't that something to look forward to?
Here's the wrapper.
Well, it looks real. Comes with two wings, a stimulated instrument panel, cockpit with leather-like seats.
We'll go in halves, but I'll make my grandfather pay for it.
Far out.
If you swallow it, the gum stays in your stomach forever.
No way.
Betcha.
Thank you.
How come your dad isn't over there fighting?
Well, on Keller's leg, he busts his knee real bad playing football. I can show you his trophy sometimes. He played in Southern Miss. He would have been a pro. Anyway, he says it was God's will.
John, I've been waiting.
Who's the retard?
I'm not retarded, I'm slow. And John is my friend, too.
Ziola, I'm not your friend. Now stop following me.
John and I are building something real special, aren't we, John? But it's a secret, so I can't say anything more.
See, I told you it was something special.
What's this polyjunk supposed to be?
Well, we just got started.
Who's we?
Him and me. See what I did, John? It's supposed to be a surprise for you.
Ziola, you cut the sides too short.
Yeah, I fixed it today.
You idiot! Get out of here!
This is all a joke, right?
No, it's an airplane.
You don't expect this to fly, do you?
Yeah, he's going to San Francisco with his mom.
Ziola, I said get out of here!
Yeah, retard, go on. Oh. Better be glad I ordered a real plane.
Let's get out of here.
Come on now. Tell me what happened.
I hate those Gibbs people.
Oh. You might not like that grandson, but the Gibbs, they just about some of the finest people God ever made. We've been staying on their place since the 30s. Never had a problem. Of course, folks around here just seem to get along no matter what's happening elsewhere. You best off not hating nobody.
Get him, boy.
Vince said he gave a huge frog yesterday.
Is that the war hero, son?
He's a captain. He flies an elf something.
Your mom ever say anything to you about going to some harebrained commune?
No, sir.
You'd tell me, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. You're on snake patrol. Well, don't get bug-eyed about it. Get out there and get it. Now. know, there ain't much frog gigging in San Francisco.
John, John, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do it, honest. I was helping. Where were you?
None of your business.
I can fix it. I can sew it back together.
You can't sew up a wing. The air will rip it up in a minute.
Fishing line.
See, all you can't help me no more. Just go home.
Okay, I don't like boys anyway. Bye.
You're still wasting your time on this junk.
Ma, just get my dad's tools.
What's that weirdo doing here?
Ciola, what are you doing here?
I'm not a weirdo. I'm his friend. I thought we were building a plane.
I don't know what she's talking about.
The lawnmower? Mother's shoe and the cotton?
Let's go.
I want to come.
No way.
What about the plane? Can I have it?
Go home, retard.
You! Shut up! I want the plane, whether it flies or not.
Just take it.
Need some help with Ezeola?
No, I'm done with people who were mean.
John told you I was mean, huh?
Yep. Mean as a snake, he said. And you know something? He's mean, too.
What's that you haul in there?
My plane.
You and John built it?
Yep. But he don't want it no more. It's mine now, and I'm gonna finish it. You can wave when you see me flying up there. I promise I'll wave back.
Sure you don't need some help?
I'm sure. Okay, bye.
Hey, I'll wave when I see you.
Bye.
You gonna stick that needle plumb through your finger.
What are y'all doing?
We are fixing a plane wing.
Oh, Lordy, an airplane? Yep, I'm building it all myself, except for the cotton here. Francis is helping me with that. Open that for me. I don't want John to come to my party.
What?
called me a retard.
That's not nice, not nice at all. John John didn't call you a retard, did he?
Nope.
And we can't just take back the invitation. Miss Claiborne already think we crazy, especially you.
Ow!
Uh-huh. Now what I done told you.
Fit like a glove.
You don't think it's too dressy? I mean, look at you.
You wear whatever makes you feel good. That's the whole point. Oh, wait. I got something.
Oh, yeah. Do you think all hippies in San Francisco dress like this?
I'm sure that hippies dress up and go to cocktail parties just like everybody else.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Now, Sam, that sonny boy.
Well, ain't he a piece of work?
Oh, my God. Don't slow down. Oh. He gonna see me.
Now, Arlene,
what?
I want you to get out and walk slowly. When he sees you, he'll be a goner. Get out.
See you at the party.
Okay.
Maybe.
I mean.
Just almost put me to sleep. You just got to learn to play a little faster music. That Donny Osmond ain't nothing. Should've let me make you a Jackson 5 cake.
I don't like the Jackson.
Yes, you do.
It's awfully nice of you, John John. Zelda, why don't you open it?
Cake, anybody? Well, butter my butt and call me a biscuit.
Hug me.
It's the prettiest thing I've ever seen. Ever. In the whole wide world. John John, look. I'm going up there with them and you can come.
Why are you still building it?
Well, you're gonna need the wings to fly all the way to San Francisco.
It ain't never gonna fly.
Yeah, it will. The pigeon angel's helping me.
Just like Donny Osmond will show up.
He'll come next time. You'll see.
Baby, get in the back. Go on.
That was so good. Maybe he doesn't like women. G.I. Joe.
What'd you expect?
A plane.
A real plane? That's ridiculous.
But you said it.
I was only talking about it. You were the one that said that you wanted to order. I think I'll go for a ride. See ya.
Sinners, you did not heed the call of Christ. So we're going to end this service by asking Brother Billy Joe to lead our hearts in prayer. Let us stand.
Lord, thank you for this day and for this church. Lord, we are nothing without your power. I humbly ask that you forgive each and every brother and sister here and ease them of their pain. I pray that you'll strengthen us so that we may go out and do your will. Father, I pray that you'll be with my family. I thank you for them. Now I pray that you'll go out into this sinner's world with us. In Jesus' name I ask. Amen.
Mr. Claiborne has no idea what things cost.
You thieving scoundrel. Put your bags in the car.
We gonna live in a commune?
Yep.
I'm not sure I know what to do in a commune.
All you do is sit around and listen to music. You'll be fine. Go on, get. Come on, we got things to do. Come on. At least take some underwear.
I can't leave. I have to stay here and learn how to walk to Jackson in them high heels if that's what it's gonna take for Sonny Boy or anybody else to notice me. I'm sorry, Sandra.
You go and get Sonny Boy.
Bye, John John.
Bye. Take care.
Where you going, Sandra?
I'm going away.
You ain't going anywhere. Get out of the car!
No.
Get out!
No!
You think you're leaving here with my boy?
Yes.
No, I don't think so. No. Matter of fact, I'll help you unpack.
Oh!
Who's gonna take care of him? Who's gonna make a living for him? You can't even make a living for yourself!
Oh.
You ain't got enough sense!
Yes, I do, Billy.
How you gonna do it, huh? Tell me, Sandra!
I can't.
Put the gun down. You hear me? John John? Put the gun down. Put it down! Thank you.
Get in the car, John. John, the car, it's gonna be all right. Come on, come on.
Must be John Claiborne.
Well, how do you know that?
You look just like him. I'm Lily. I was Billy Joel's housekeeper until a week ago.
He screwed up, but it's not really his fault.
What kind of language is that, young man? Did you change your mind?
Thank you.
Lord knows what I'm gonna do with all this stuff. Take anything you want. Billy Joe used to come in here and just sit. I used to hate to dust this room. He'd practically turn purple if I didn't put everything back exactly where it belonged.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'll be in the car.
You take your time. Did you take my $20 bill sitting on that dining room table? I asked you a question.
Are you crazy, lady?
Well, you right about that. Most folks think I'm crazy as a loon. Now, where's my $20? I guess you better reach down in your pocket and give me my darn money. That's just about how your daddy spent his whole childhood. I reckon a little compassion would go a long way right about now. Here it is. I reckon that jaw Joe preserves.
What's that thing?
It's a frog gig.
A what?
It's good for catching snakes. I didn't want this, but that woman was pretty adamant about me taking it.
Hey, wait a minute! I almost just plumb forgot. You ought to stop by and see Ziola's place.
my Lord! Oh, my Lord! Oh, my goodness! Oh, my Lord! Oh, my goodness! Oh, don't he look the spitting image of you? Oh, oh, oh. You missed the funeral.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess that was kind of hard to track down. So, Zeola's doing pretty well for herself, huh?
Oh, honey, Zeola passed away about 3 years ago. Who would have thought it? Your daddy and Zeola, the best of friends. And you know what started it?
When Zeola crashed that plane y'all built.
So one of that thing didn't kill her. Billy Joe rushed to patch her up and, well, you know how Zeola latched on. Oh, look at you. It was your daddy's idea to build this place. Zeola, well, it was right up her alley. She was a hard worker, and business was good, because you know everybody just loves Zeola. And they brought me in to watch the money, keep the books. Yeah. And Lord, look like I'm just going to die, ironing clothes. Oh, look at this one. Oh, my goodness. Come on here, let me show you something. Come on. See these cars here? They're from all over America. Now, Zeola, she was waiting for a car from that special someone to put up there.
Probably Donnie Osmond.
Nope. Got one from him. See right there? Mm-hmm. Now, these cars here, they from your mama. She must have bought every postcard in Texas. I knew she wouldn't make it across that Texas state line.
Erlaine, you were there the day we left.
Oh, Lord, honey. You barely grazed his arm. You couldn't have done that man a bigger favor. I know what your mama told you. That you killed him. But she just didn't want you to have a reason to ever come back here. He told everybody he was cleaning his gun.
Well, I got a postcard to send. That's why I was thinking about going to San Francisco. And, you want to walk home anyway, so... Interstate's a few miles, you can probably hitchhike home from there.
Are you kidding?
Depends. Tell you what, I'll make you a deal. You be the little kid for a while, and I'll give you a ride home.
Dad, who's Donnie Osmond?